Lee, broken up by Martin. Out to Sanderson. He's shoved and dumped by McKay. Here's Rick Smith. And now McKay and Sanderson going at it. Right at the Boston line. Bailey jumps in. Johnston out of his net to try and pull McKay off. Bailey's in there. Trying to pull him apart. Neil Armstrong trying to dig in there, along with Pat Shetler. Dennis Hull drags Westfall down. He's held by Rick Smith. Well, as we said earlier, linesmen earn every nickel of it. Well, Sanderson's got the shirt off McKay. That's his trophy. Sanderson throws off the stick of Nielsen as he slows Westfall down. Here comes Sealing. He's tied up, and Rick Smith has the puck. And now, here we go. Curtain back in Sanderson. Sandy getting that hand free. Everybody's grabbed a partner. Sandy and Kurtenbach, this first broke out 2 years ago. And Sandy's been aching for a chance to even things up. Sandy throwing right-hand bombs from over the outstretched arms of Matt Pavlich, finally separating the two. Now Ed Jockerman comes out of the net to have a few words to say to Derek Sanderson. That is an unprecedented move. Normally a goaltender will mind his own business and stay where he's put. But Jockerman skated right out to the faceoff circle and started to jaw with Sanderson. Now Sanderson throwing a warning finger toward the Rangers bench as a few remarks came out from there. On the faceoff. Shot by Marcotte. Goes behind the New York net as Brad Park throws a good check on Marcotte. Puck loose in the corner. Sanderson double-teamed, and here we go. Everyone on the ice piles on. Sanderson is on the bottom as the Rangers have ganged up on Derek Sanderson. Marcotte's trying to tear him apart. Sanderson still throwing from both sides. Marcotte's got a hold of Tkachuk. Now Tkachuk has him backed up against the boards. Sanderson still flailing away. Tkachuk was on one side, and I believe it was Brad Park on the other side. They just ganged up on them. And started hitting them, one from either side. Well, sir, if this series does return to Boston, that should be a most interesting game Tuesday night. Westfall holding off one man. Now Tkachuk goes after him again. The Bruins perched on the edge of the dasher at their side of the rink. Rangers still trying to get something rolling here in the corner. There's Arnie Brown. It would seem apparent the plan of attack was to wear Derek Sanderson out right off the opening bell. And this could take its toll on Boston. Now D'Amico brings Sanderson over to the Boston bench and is talking with. Now Sanderson. Harry Sinden has erupted. I would guess that Ashley has assessed a game misconduct to Derek Sanderson. And Harry Sinden just went into orbit. Kurtenbach shot save. Penalty coming up. And it looks as though it's against Boston. Now Cashman and Park going at it. Kurtenbach moves in. And here we go again. Kurtbach getting in his licks on Cashman. Now Cashman comes back, and he pins him into the corner as they let each other go. Down on the ice. Back up again. Kurtbach trying to raise Cashman's sweater. Both Shetler and DeMarco are letting the two go and let them get it out of their system. Now they move in again. Kurtbach still flailing away on Cashman. Trying to break loose. Kurtbach now broken apart by Pat Shetler. Cashman's got it. Checked hard, and now Horton and he glare at each other. Here we go, Horton and Wayne Cashman. From view now, we've got the end zone camera on as they go back into the corner again. Cashman trying to get leverage. He's down on his back. Now McKenzie tussling with Rattel. Cashman is blocked from our view as he is from yours, as Horton is back up again. You can see the number three. Cashman back on his feet, being held by Red Shetler. 40 seconds left in the period. Here's Béliveau, out to Tremblay. Across to LaPointe. Shot kicked out by Johnson. Redmond blocked by Dallas Smith. He's upended, and we've got a penalty coming up to Boston, Dallas Smith. It looked like tripping John right in the slot.
Well, I'll tell you, the Bruins no sooner get one man out of the penalty box than one goes in, and there's Hodge going at LaRose here at center ice. They're both dropping their gloves. The linesman stepping in the way right here. Right below us, Mihaljevic comes off the bench for Canadians, and that'll draw a little fire, as we have more than the required amount of players on the ice from both teams. Now here's LaPointe and Cashman going at it at center, and Cashman can really throw them. They're both going at it toe-to-toe. Oh, and LaPointe caught Cashman a good right hand. And there's Sanderson now getting involved in there, and they're all coming off. Both benches are emptying. Even Cheevers is coming on. And we're going to have a Donnybrook right down below us here as both benches emptied.
John Forrestal clearing the entire bench of gloves and sticks. Ori and Lemire down below us. Well, trying to figure out who's paired off with who is rather difficult. Cashman, a bad gash on the right eye. And now another one breaks out. Right at center ice. It looks like, from here, Ken Hodge and Vachon piles on. Johnston joins in. Tremblay and Dallas Smith. Harper is involved. Hodge is in there.
Cashman's got a very bad gash over his right eye, but he wants to get involved in somebody here.
A good left hand by Cashman. Taking on two men. LaRose and McKenzie right down below us. I think it was Vachon that Cashman really clocked. And now Sanderson on the Montreal bench area as the Boston police step in. Fans getting involved. The player, I believe, is Phil Roberto.
Yeah.
Sanderson being held by two Boston policemen. Right down below us at the Montreal bench area. There's Derek Sanderson right there. I think we ought to call in Don Dumphy, John.
Well, I don't know, Don. I think that naturally very unnecessary, certainly well out of hand, and you could see the feelings were running very high through this whole first period. Lots of body checking. There was a lot of stick work going on, slashing people's feet, and very unnecessary. I don't know if you could say, Ashley, let the game get out of hand.
There are those who say that this is the wildest fight that's ever erupted at Boston Garden. As you can see now, that's Phil Roberto, who strangely enough is the fellow that Derek Sanderson was fighting with on the ice and then in the Montreal bench area. The two of them, ironically enough, grew up together in Niagara Falls and have been good buddies for a long time. It does kind of swell over into the area of the fans. One fan caught a pretty good one that sent him down. Out of this whole thing came a total of 32 minutes of penalties. The two that were given to Dallas Smith for tripping, which started the whole thing off, and then there were 3 5-minute penalties on each side, 3 to Boston and 3 to Montreal. Let's go back now to Don Earl and John Pearson for more description of the rumble.
Close to the Canadians, and he's trying to break it up, but he's getting some rough treatment down there. And they're finally getting the players back on the ice. But I don't know how Ashley's ever going to make head or tail of this thing, because I'm as confused as anybody about Hodge started it, really, down there and at center ice. But we've got a problem now. Boston police are around the Canadian bench. That's where the activity has centered over the last 5 or 6 minutes. And Roberto is pointing to somebody about something that happened while he was in the crowd fighting with Sanderson. Somebody from behind must have taken a swing at Roberto. But he and Cash, Sanderson and Don, I don't understand how Sanderson got over onto the Canadian bench to start with.
Well, this I can't figure out either, John, but when all of a sudden the ruckus started, there he was right on the bench.
But it sure broke up the fights between the players in a hurry with that action going on behind the Canadian's bench with the Boston police involved in it. And now all the players are milling around. And it'll be some time now before this is straightened away. But if I were John Ashley, I think I'd suspend the 27 seconds left to play in this period and send the teams to their dressing rooms and start the 27 seconds at the start of the second period. I think that would probably be the smartest thing here. I think that we need a cooling off period, definitely. And right now is as good a time as any, as far as I can see.
It makes a lot of sense, John, because time does wonders in a situation like this, and I think both clubs could benefit from it.
There's Cashman. You just saw him go over in there. There's a right hand, left hand. He's got a tremendous left. The players were telling a funny story about Cashman with that left hand. They feel that he's going to throw the right, and he comes in with that sneak left. He's got a tremendous left hook, and he...
Sanderson's there. He's checked, double-teamed by Nestorenko and Magnuson, and here we go. Magnuson and Sanderson. A bear hug as Sanderson tries to get a bit of leverage. Really, nothing of any damaging nature happening between the two of them. It's pretty much a wrestling match as both Ron Ego and Pat Shetler move in.
I'd have to say, Don, that looks like a love-in over there now. They're hugging each other. Now, neither one of them wants to let go first, because that's when things are liable to happen. But the linesman, Pat Shetler, is moving in there very quickly now, and we're going to have penalties.
Shetler holds off Sanderson, and now Ego finally... Now Rick Smith and Dan Maloney are going down. In the corner, Rick Smith and Dan Maloney. Ari trying to get in there, and now it's a four-way go as West falls in there. Magnuson trying to get loose from Ron Ego. And Rick Smith and Maloney start up again. Maloney and Rick Smith, with Ari being held up by Pat Stapleton. Nestorenko in the corner with Westfall, and Gotti with a hold of Busick. And both Maloney and Rick Smith have now been parted. And here we go again. Ari trying to get in between them is hauled off by Stapleton. Johnston moves in, and now Desjardins moves in. Magnuson trying to get in there. Westfall trying to hold Nestorenko up. Correction, I believe that's Chico Mackey.
That's Nestorenko, John, over there with Westfall.
The 15 looked like a 16 there for a moment. Rick Smith on the bottom. Maloney sitting on him. And now Ron Wicks finally waves Magnuson to the box, something which should have been done some time ago. Tied up by Fleming. Hodge gets it back to Cashman. Espo trying to get position in front. And now Fleming and Cashman. Here we go. Orr is trying to pull Fleming apart. Hodge gets by Barry. It all happened right after the whistle. Cashman's up and going at Fleming with the left hand. Once he gets that left hand loose, he's about as dangerous a man in this situation there is in the National Hockey League. There goes that left hand again. Cashman and Fleming still flailing away. And now here we go. The whole benches are empty. Both benches have emptied. For a long period, John, we thought we'd seen the end of it this year. Things seem to have been quieted down around the league, but all it takes is a flare-up like this to start something of this nature.
Well, Don, actually, Cashman was getting the better of Fleming, and you could see that he was definitely on top. And Buffalo, realizing it, sent a couple of men off the bench, which is what started this whole thing. And, of course, when that starts, the Bruins came right on as well. And then there were three or four of them throwing punches at each other. It was hard to tell who was fighting whom, but it seems to have subsided now. But it all started with Fleming and Cashman, as Fleming really rammed into Cashman behind the Buffalo net, and that's when the thing all started.
To Mackey, Bobby Hull shoots wide. Ravlich trying to move it out. Deflects. Here's Magnuson and Cashman going. Look at that left. Look at that left of Cashman. Cashman down. Look at Magnuson. Oh, what a fight. Cashman, tremendous here. Oh, there's one of the best fights you'll see anywhere. And Magnuson trying to tear his hair out as Cashman is back to poke him away. And both go down. John, that was some battle.
Well, the best here tonight.
Here's the slow motion replay, and nothing slow about that action. That's the replay there. And we almost have to come back to live action. Here they are in replay. Penalty hooking Magnuson for interference, and there's O'Reilly hitting Magnuson, and they're going at it. Terry O'Reilly and Keith Magnuson right away, squaring off. O'Reilly and Magnuson, and a good one here. And they both land. Rugged competition right at the outset as they both go down now. Terry O'Reilly and Keith Magnuson. gets the puck to Nick Beverly. Fed in, but blocked by Serge Savard, a very steady player. Here's O'Reilly going and shot and Frank for Hamlet. Oh, he's pounded away on Frank. And the others are held off. O'Reilly handled Frank Mahovlich and just pounded him.
Well, there's no doubt about who's the most popular player on the Bruins right at this moment. Terry O'Reilly has played himself a pretty fair hockey game here tonight. He's stick-handled. He's really gone after the Canadians, and he ran into Ken Dryden just moments ago, and now he's battling with Frank Mahovlich. Comes here. Now this is the high sticking that started it all. There's O'Reilly and Frank Mahovlich, and finally Frank throws the punch that starts it, and O'Reilly knocks him down and goes down on top of him, and boy, he lets him have it about three or four before Frank can get him tied up. And from that point on, it seemed to work out to be just a wrestling match.
Across the ice to do it. O'Reilly and Thompson start to exchange greetings. Here they go. Thompson and O'Reilly. Just a bear hug for the moment. Floyd Thompson and O'Reilly, and down goes O'Reilly, Thompson atop him. Beverly clears it in. And Cashman in to prevent icing. Look out for Schoenfeld, and look at that. Schoenfeld wrapped him right through the door. And here they go off the ice. I've never seen that before.
Well, they're in the alleyway when Schoenfeld bumped Cashman into the boards going for that icing infraction. The two doors open up where the machine comes out, Zamboni comes out. And Cashman and Schoenfeld fell down, and they went really at it. They're still going. The two linesmen are in there trying to break it up, but are not having too much success, as you can see. Cashman and Schoenfeld in behind the glass or the partition. That's where the Zamboni comes out.
Oh, it's a bad scene now.
Shepard is involved in there. Dallas Smith's in there.
Walton is battling Tracy Pratt.
Orr is down on the floor. We can't see him from here. Joe Crozier is being held by Ken Hodge. Joe Crozier, the coach. And we have Bedlam around the Buffalo bench.
Now, Jim Lorenz and Don Marcotte. And Don Orr and Gil Perreault. But it was Orr, the last we saw, piling into that bench on Larry Hillman.
Bobby is up now. He's got his sweater half torn off. I only hope that knee is not damaged any further down in that Buffalo bench. It certainly would be a very, very sad state of affairs if what has gone on here was...
Here's O'Reilly and Jim Lorenz. Look at this. O'Reilly with that left. Lorenz, tremendous. But here comes O'Reilly. Lorenz is standing on the bench, and he's got better posture than O'Reilly. But I tell you, I've seen enough tonight, John.
Fred, there's only one word for this whole thing, and that's got to be ridiculous.
Puck is fed out. And O'Reilly and Frank Mahovlich start to square off. They drop the gloves, and they go at it. They do. Good right by Frank. O'Reilly likes the left. O'Reilly and Frank Mahovlich.
O'Reilly and Frank Mahovlich going at it. The referee and the two linesmen standing aside as O'Reilly throws that left. And we'll have penalties here.
Hit by Doak. Trailing, Thompson keeps it in to Angotti, and his shot went wide. Bruins stopped. Doak battling Angotti. And Angotti is going out as Doak starts to jam, and Doak is cut.
I think we may see a high sticking penalty here, Fred, and if we do, it could be a 5-minute major penalty to Angotti. I think that's what the call is going to be.
O'Donnell and Gassoff square off.
We've got a real good one going here with Gassoff and O'Donnell. Doak comes into the play. And we're going to have some third men in here as Gassoff and O'Donnell go at it.
A really rugged fight between O'Donnell and Gassoff. Now Doak is ready to go at Angotti. Doak was cut. And he's warned by Gilmore now. He's going out, I think, as the third man in that O'Donnell-Gassoff affair. And O'Donnell trying to knock Gassoff down, but O'Donnell winds up on the bottom as Gilmore, the referee, comes over to separate the players. O'Donnell trying to pull the jersey off Gassoff. Doak in there to help out again.
Fred, this all started when Doak went up against the boards with Angotti, and it looked like Angotti's stick caught him in the face. The referee, Lloyd Gilmore, blew the whistle, but we've got four battles going on here.
Riley checking. Here he goes with Schultz right away. They just tangled. It was inevitable, and it's happening early. O'Reilly and Schultz head to head. Tremendous left by O'Reilly. But Schultz grabs his jersey and throws some solid rights. What a battle. Lead pass for Forbes. Forbes in, and a penalty coming up. And O'Reilly and McElhaughey. Oh, a rugged battle. Look at them go. And down goes O'Reilly on the bottom, and McElhaughey, one of the hard rock defensemen up from the American Hockey League, he gave Riley a check after Riley hit him earlier. And finally, the linesmen move in, and that was some kind of battle. Forbes and Schultz, and here's O'Reilly moving in on Schultz. And there they go. O'Reilly and Schultz. And they've battled before in the American Hockey League, and this is O'Reilly's second fight. And listen to the crowd. As DuPont and Forbes are squared away. And O'Reilly now holding on as he had the early going, and Schultz wants to get started here. And O'Reilly is... We've had some real heavyweight goals. O'Reilly and Schultz. Oh. O'Reilly. O'Reilly carried the brunt in that one. Now Schultz ready to go again, and O'Reilly wants to rest and divide the fight in the rounds. Listen to the applause for Terry O'Reilly.
And McNabb runs into Glennie. Now a Garland hit by Stan Jonathan. They tangle over on the boards, and there they go. Jonathan and Garland, but kind of wrestling now. Back off and throw a few. Jonathan has a left. And still wants to go. He's lost his helmet. And he throws some good ones in there. And this is Milbury. Schultz coming back on Jonathan. And they go head to head. Schultz pounding away at Jonathan. Schultz, one of the best fighters. Jonathan coming back. Rattling some good rights and left as they hold with one hand and go at it. One of the best fights, Schultz and Jonathan. Off goes the helmet. A real go here. Stan Jonathan and Dave Schultz. That was not a penalty. A rattling check.